Welcome to tonight's broadcast. My name is Pish, the Purity Ambassador, and tonight we are handling the deception of prayer. Now, you need to understand there are things we can do during prayer to nullify the authenticity or the effectiveness of prayer. Because the Bible says that the prayer of a righteous man availeth much. But you see, there are some few deceptions that accompany us into the place of prayer, though righteous yield no results. And the first deception of prayer is masking. Now, masking is a state where you go to prayer and act to God that maybe you are grateful and you know you're not. You know, you express your gratitude and your happiness and joy and love. And you know, in the state of your heart, it is not true. And you see, prayer, God requires sincerity. In fact, sometimes most powerful prayers or the most effective prayers are prayers that we pray from a point of sincerity. Just approaching God and telling Him, Father, I am hurt, I am in pain, I am not happy. Today so and so insulted me. You know, it is a place of, you know, unmask yourself. Don't go to prayer masked up. Number two, don't pray from a place of obligation. You know, where you are competing or beating against time, where you want to pray for 3 hours, and so you maybe you have even an alarm, or you just are praying to beat time. Those are obligational prayers, and sometimes they are not effective. And then number three, it is when we trust in prayer more than we trust in God. Sometimes I have seen this, and maybe I have been a victim of, you know, when I quote these three scriptures and use these vocabularies and terminologies and expressions in prayer, I will sound powerful to God. And you see, that does not affect God. God, is not concerned about what you're saying, but the state of your heart. And so you see a lot of, you know, vocabularies and mastering the language of certain scriptures in the Bible makes you sound powerful, although you don't mean what you're saying. And so that develops or builds a faith to prayer itself rather than to the one you're praying to. And so we have to be sincere and very sensitive that our trust and faith is not in prayer, but to the Lord that we are praying to. And then there is the place of posture. You've been made to believe that if you kneel down or lie flat, you know, or you fast not out of conviction, but to look spiritual. That also is not effective, because it is religion. It is, you know, it is obligational religiosity that you have to do 1, 2, 3 things to look spiritual. Because I can be kneeling physically, but in my heart I'm standing. And so the place of the deception of posture also is key. So watch your prayer, keep on praying. A man that prays is a powerful man, and therefore may our prayer life yield results. May our prayer life, you know, be effective and even affect us and the people around us. See you soon.